everyone. Welcome back to another keto mukbang and a movie. Tonight I have made a keto style cheeseburger mushroom hot dish and we're going to watch the movie Courageous. Welcome back. Super excited about tonight's keto dinner. The whole pan was 12 carbs split between both my husband and I. We each got 6 carbs here. And like I said in the beginning, it is a cheeseburger, mushroom, hot dish, casserole, whatever you want to call it. But it is super easy to make. At the end, you will see a slideshow, all the ingredients and everything. But of course, I like to tell you in the beginning here, and also I will have it wrote down in my box. I am drinking it with a water enhancer. It's the Kool-Aid liquid water enhancer. I'm doing the cherry one. And what this is here is a full bag of the cauliflowered rice, the frozen one, a pound of organic hamburger, the very lean one, and then it's got a can of mushrooms in it, and then I bought a jar of Ragu creamy cheese sauce. And all together with, like I said, the whole pan, after you make everything and you put it together and bake it in the oven, it is 12 carbs for the whole pan, so we get to split that whole pan in half. I mean, there's a lot here, and it's only 6 carbs each, so it's awesome. But it's got the cheese sauce. So what I did was 1 full bag of the cauliflowered rice, a pound of the ground organic hamburger, 3/4 cups of the cheesy, creamy sauce, whatever it is, the Ragu, and then 1 can of the can of mushrooms, and then on top is just 1 cup of, or half a cup, I'm sorry, half a cup of mozzarella cheese at the very end. You bake at the very end or whatever on the top. Now, to make this lower for you guys, because this would be a little bit heavier fat, is you do it with ground turkey, don't do the mozzarella cheese, and then it's going to be lower for you guys because the creamy cheese sauce is enough fat right there for you guys. So just don't add the mozzarella and do it with ground turkey. But I did do it with a very lean ground beef. And I also, you'll see in the pictures, I also wash my ground beef with hot water. So I get off all the, you know, all the extra grease and everything, which just didn't have a lot of grease because it was already lean, but I got even more off of it. But yeah, that's the way you guys would do it. But definitely this is a meal that you could have, even though it's a little bit higher, you could definitely have it, just don't have it often, or make it the way I said, then you can have it more often. So super excited about this. And it's just got a little bit of salt and pepper. We are doing the movie Courageous. My friend Jennifer on here, Jennifer, I'm doing this one for you. It is a Christian movie, very good movie. And it's based on 4, I think they're all dads, right? Yeah, 4 dads. And let's see, what does it say on the back here? I'll just read it to you. As law enforcement officer Adam Mitchell, Nathan Hayes, and their partners willingly stand up against the worst the world can offer, yet at the end of the day, they face a challenge that none of them are truly prepared to tackle: fatherhood. While they constantly give their best on the job, they quickly discover that their children are beginning to drift further away from them. When tragedy hits home, these men are left with a newfound urgency to renew their faith and reach out to their own children. Will they be able to find a way to serve and protect those who are most dear to them? So it is a great movie for fathers. I know Mother's Day is coming, but I'm doing this one right now. It's a great movie for you fathers out there, but even mothers too, of, you know, being a parent in itself is, you know, not an easy job, but we do need to listen to our kids and, you know, sit down and spend time with them and try to do the best we can, especially as Christians, to teach them the, you know, to teach them about God, to walk with God and all that. But this truly is a great movie, so can't wait to share this with you guys. Now, I won't be sharing many clips because on my channel, sometimes I get like a flag before I even put it up. I have it in lockdown, so I don't want to get in trouble for it. So I'm only going to show a few clips, but I'll talk a little bit about it with you guys because I really do enjoy it. It is a Christian movie. Got it from the Christian bookstore. So if you're interested, it's called Courageous. And then if it doesn't go up, if it does get taken from me, I will have an alternate ending for you guys and just rent the movie then, or I'm sorry, or get the movie. You'll love it. So let's go ahead and dig into this 6 carb hot dish. Yum. Yum, yum. The only difference here that for like a cheeseburger dish would be I'm not using noodle, I'm using riced cauliflower. Look at that. Doesn't that look yummy? Look at the steam coming off of it. Ooh, yum. Wow, that's really good. And it's got the mushrooms in it. If you don't like mushrooms, you can replace the mushrooms with something else, maybe broccoli or a little bit of green pepper. But the mushrooms were really low for the whole entire can, net carb. It's only one carb for the whole pan. Did you like dinner, honey?
You cease to amaze me. Every keto dish is good. I mean, I have to go on this diet, though, because I want to do like a before and after like you did.
Yep.
Because I'm getting way out of shape, and I want to do it.
My husband isn't super overweight, but he's about 200, what are you, 210?
Can they see in the mirror?
No.
No,
he's around 208 to 210, and he's 6 foot, but he would like to see himself around the 170s, and he hasn't been feeling very good lately, but carbs will do that to you. So after, like I told you guys before, I was pretty simple with all of my meals, but now for you guys, I've been making better meals to show you that keto can be really fun, and he's actually enjoying all these meals, so he thinks he wants to switch over and do this with me.
Well,
so.
No, I got...
Look at that, guys. Yum.
I got three issues. I got digestive issues. I got inflammation right there. And what's the other thing? Oh, the water retention.
Yeah, so see...
keto will take all three away.
Yep. That's see, he's reading. Been reading himself, too, about keto. So, yes, it will definitely take it away. But, oh, my gosh, you guys, this flavor is really good. It does taste like I'm eating a cheeseburger hot dish with, like, noodles. It almost does taste like that. I mean, look at all that, and it's creamy, and it's good. And the Ragu itself, for every fourth a cup, it's only 2 carbs. So I use 3/4 a cup for the whole recipe. But like I said, I always will mark it down in my box in case I forgot something or exactly how to make it. And then, of course, there's a slideshow at the end for you guys, for those of you that watch the full video. So, I really like the mushrooms in it. I'm not a real big mushroom person unless I cook them. Now, these are a can. I do like the ones in a can. I like them, like, sautéed in soy sauce. In here, like, in hot dishes, they're really, really good. Then I like them. I don't really care for, like, fresh mushrooms or mushrooms out, except for, like, the Outback. I really love their mushrooms done in their sauce. But, of course, since keto, I haven't touched them because I don't know what's on it. I don't know how many carbs would be in that. So I just like to make it myself. But I really enjoy mushrooms if I make them myself. And they taste excellent in this. Do you see them on there? Oh, my God, they're so good. I know a lot of you are going to like this one. This one is... Like they say, that comfort food. It definitely is a comfort food.
Look at, even Minnie is a keto. Mm-hmm. She's eating all of it.
My husband left just a tiny bit on his plate, and our doggy's eating it. I almost forgot to get the movie going. So, but yeah, this movie is really great. Like I said, it just teaches fathers how to be a better father, spend more time with your children. At the end, they all do like a ceremony dedicating themselves like over to their children and stuff. It's really a great movie. There's parts in here how some dads aren't involved in their kids' life. Some are. Some of them are Christians. Some of them aren't Christians in here. So it's really an interesting movie. I really, really like it. And it just shows just true like parenting, but true fatherhood. Like, because, you know, it's mothers, you know, I'm not saying a father or a mother is better than a father, but mothers, you know, we're more nurturing and loving and we have the time to do all that. And a father's, they're a little bit more busy or they're working all day long and they're doing their things. So they don't have the time like a mother does. But it really is important for a father to spend his time with his children and, you know, just listen to what they have to say, pray with them, you know, just, it's important. And it's really sad because one of the fathers in here, one of the Christian fathers, loses his daughter. She passes away, and that's so sad. But he has to accept it, and he has to understand that God took her home and that he needs to remember that he has a son, too. And because he kind of was distant from his son, wasn't spending a lot of time with his son and stuff, but always, you know, giving his time to his daughter. So it's almost like God was saying, you have another child that you need to pay attention to, too, you know. So I'm not saying God is awful and takes babies away. Excuse me. I did not mean to burp on here. Hope you guys didn't hear that. But it's not that he loved his daughter more than his son. It's just that he realized he wasn't spending enough time with his son. So his daughter was pretty young, too, when she died. I think it was a drunk driver that hit her. Now, this movie isn't based on a true story, but stories like that happen all over the world. So I love these Christian movies. And I'm doing this, like I said, for Jennifer. I forgot her last name. But she watches my channel. She'll know who she is. She requested that I would do the Courageous one because she's seen me do a few Christian movies. So, and I told her I would love to because it's one of my favorites. I love all the Christian movies. Mm. This is so hearty and so good. Yum, I love it so much. And like I've taught you guys, you really need to look into organic meats. This one, I actually found at Aldi's. Sometimes you can, but for those of you that don't have an Aldi's, Walmart has organic hamburger, you know, grass-fed animals and stuff. That's what you really want to invest in because we eat a lot of meat, so they need to be the good meats. It's important in our body, and I learn as I go too, but so simple. Cauliflower rice, organic hamburger, mushrooms, the sauce, the cheese sauce or whatever, and a little bit of more mozzarella cheese on top, salt and pepper. Really easy to make. After everything's together, the cauliflower rice, we, I, of course, you know, do in the microwave. You cook up your hamburger, then basically you just put everything in a bowl, you'll see, and you're mixing it, and then you just put it in the oven on 400 for 25 minutes, and then you take it out and put the mozzarella cheese on top, if you're gonna do the mozzarella cheese, and then put it back in for 5 more minutes. So easy to make, quick, easy. Your dinner's done, literally, like your whole dinner's done in like 40 minutes. That's cooking the hamburger and putting everything together. It's a quick, easy meal to make. And you can make it even quicker. Well, no, that's, yeah, that's the quickest I can do because I did it in the microwave, that's right. So it's the quickest you can do, but 40 minutes and your dinner's ready, not bad. This would be even easy to explain to a husband to make because it's so easy. I mean, how hard is it to cook hamburger? Take your cooked cauliflower rice that's done in the microwave, pour the hamburger, the cauliflower rice, the 3/4 cups of the cheese sauce, the can of mushrooms, salt and pepper, mix it, put it in the oven. 400 for 25 minutes. So easy. But it packs a big punch, and this is really good, and I'm already getting full. That pan had so much in it. When you add all this stuff, there's a lot to this. Mmm. This would definitely be a food I know most of you are really going to love. I know Monica and Dave, my good friends, will really, really love this one. Monica and Dave, it's really hearty, really delicious, and very filling. Very, very filling. My husband couldn't even finish his plate. And what I made here for that particular pan was for 2 servings. If you need to make 4 servings, if you have 4 people, you're going to double everything. If you need to make it for just 1 person, you're just going to take away one of the, you know, one of the amounts. So it would be half the rice, half the hamburger, you know, half of everything. If you're doing it for 3 people, it would be 1.5. So just keep going like that. If you have 6 people, you're going to triple it. You know what I mean? So it's pretty simple to put this together. And I don't know anybody, even a child, that wouldn't like this. It's very good. And you don't taste the cauliflower rice when it's cooked like this. You just don't. But it's giving you the veggie, your cauliflower, and then your mushrooms. And if you wanted to, you could even do less of the pan and have a salad with it. You could do that too. I've already gotten my greens in for the day, so I didn't have to. But if you still needed your greens, then you would just do less the pan so that it would take some of the carb away. And then you would do a spinach salad, a spring salad, a romaine salad, just some kind of a salad to give you your green. Or a side of broccoli. That would work too. Oh, this is so yummy, so filling, holy moly. But I can't stop, it's so good. Again, this one almost tastes like the tater tot hot dish I did, although things are different. There's no green beans in here. It's done with Alfredo sauce, the other one, and heavy cream. This one was just done with the cheese sauce, but it does. It tastes almost like a tater tot hot dish. It's definitely a hot dish, but it is different flavored from the other one. Definitely different. Mmm. And I love how you can take something and make it even lower fat, you know, because this wouldn't be too fat, but it is higher fat because of the cheese sauce and then the mozzarella cheese on top and then the ground beef. So it's as simple as changing it to ground turkey. Still going to taste really good. And then the cheese sauce, you can add, you know, maybe 2 1/4 cups and then just, you know, a little bit of the cheese, or you could do just the cheese sauce and no mozzarella cheese, or you could do just... You definitely need the cheese sauce in there, though. That you definitely need. So the only thing you could eliminate would be the mozzarella cheese or a little bit of the cheese sauce and do the mozzarella cheese. But I would say you still need the 3/4 of cups, the 3 1/4 cups, because it's, you know, you don't want it to be too dry. And this is just perfect. There's a part right here where his son is asking him to run with him for his school. And his dad's like, I don't have time to. And you got to do your grades and everything. And you got to keep your grades up and stuff like that. And then his wife looks and said, you got to spend more time with him, you know. They need, in school, they need a dad to run with them, like a partner. So. So yummy. And then at the very end, because I didn't do a lot of salt and pepper, it was to taste, I did wait for the very end too to add a little bit more salt and pepper on my plate. See, and he's being really good to the daughter right now, and that's where the son gets upset, because he sees that. He's like, I just asked my dad to do something, and he won't, but yet he's being so good to her. Now, I'm not saying God is an evil man and took his daughter from him because of it. It just, God knew when she was going to be taken, so it was not anything like that. Like, God had, you know, God has his plan, how everything in life's going to happen. But it teaches him a lesson, because, I mean, she went to heaven to be with the Lord, so it's not a bad thing. But it teaches him that he needs to spend more time with his son, too, you know. It wasn't just all about her. And it draws the family closer. And God does things for a reason, you know. I'm so full. I hope all you mothers had a nice Mother's Day. I actually said in the beginning that, you know, this is a Father's thing and Mother's Day is coming up. I meant to say, by the time you guys get this video, Mother's Day hasn't come for me yet. This is Thursday before Mother's Day. But by the time you guys get this, it will be Mother's. It will be past Mother's Day. So I hope all of you guys had, all of you ladies had a nice Mother's Day. And all of you dads that have stepped up and played the role as a mom, you get to be, you know, you get to celebrate this special day too. Gonna finish this last bite here, even though I'm stuffed. If I can get it up on here. This was really yummy. And quick and easy to put together. I love meals like that. Like I said, I've come up with some really great meals and you guys are loving them. And I still got many, many more to come. I started doing more for breakfast and more for lunch, even though I don't eat breakfast, but I do sometimes. My first meal is my breakfast lunch, so sometimes I do a breakfast food, sometimes I do a lunch food. So I'm kind of just mixing it up and showing you guys different things for those of you that do eat breakfast or do eat lunch and dinners. You know, I'm trying to do a little variety. I won't be doing many mukbangs with movies, though. One of the videos you would have seen, unless you haven't seen it yet, if you did, I explained that I wasn't doing movies anymore. I'll do this one here that I'm doing. If you haven't seen that video yet, then it's probably going to be kind of the end of the movies, but I'm still going to suggest movies to you guys. It's just, I don't want to get in trouble. I'm getting to 1,000 subscribers and I'm going to be monetized pretty soon and I don't want to get in trouble on my channel. So I will still suggest movies to you guys and stuff like that, but I won't be showing a lot of the clips. And this one here, I'll show a few clips for you and hopefully it'll go up. If not, then definitely just, like I said, invest in getting this movie because it's really great. Otherwise, I think that's all I have to say to you guys. Hope you enjoyed this mukbang here, and now we will get going on to the clips, and I'll talk a little bit more about the movie. So this is the very beginning of the movie. This guy here is going to be working at the police department with the other guys. He's new to this town. He went to go get some windshield washer to clean his window, and this guy is stealing his truck. Now, he normally wouldn't jump like that. Nobody would do that to try to get your vehicle. You just let it go and call the police. But his baby son is in the back seat.
Nathan Hayes. Been wondering how I recognize your name. Adam Mitchell.
Shane Coleman.
Hey, good to meet you.
Meet you.
So why Albany? I wanted to move back to give my family a better pace. slower pace.
Well, I'd say welcome back, but I hate to say it after such a rotten day.
Well, my son is okay, so I still say it's a good day.
See? Think about it. His family, it's sad. The husband's trying to keep his job, get work for his family, and can't find work, but he's a very faithful man to God.
Javi, what are you doing home?
But see, even Christians go through hard times. God puts you through tests.
Let me go.
What?
And test your faith.
I was the last one hired and they went over budget.
Why didn't you call me? I could have talked to them. We've got two children to feed.
I tried to tell him that.
Anyway, you dance right here and I'll watch.
There's that young girl. I bet you he wishes he would have danced with her. He does remember this part, and it's really sad.
When you're ready to dance, this is what you do. First, you put your right hand around my waist like this. Then, you hold your other hand out like this. Then, you sway back and forth to the music.
And speaking of dads, the email was shared for the other day. Think the thing was accurate?
I do. I grew up seeing that kind of stuff all the time. Now I wonder where all the good fathers went to. Ain't that the truth?
What? What are you talking about your dad? I mean, like an usher or something at your church?
Yeah, that doesn't mean anything. As soon as the church service started, he'd step out back for a smoke. You know, one time, he says to me, I better not catch your drink.
So here he gets offered another job,
yeah,
and it's another turn down.
Yeah, my name's Javier Martinez. I was told to come see you for work.
Oh, man, I just hired the last three guys I need. Sorry, man, we're good to go.
Well, I can do most anything, sir. I can do woodwork, brickwork, even drywall.
Listen, man, I said I got what I need, all right? Unless someone quits, I don't need you.
Not sad. This part's so cool. As he's standing there asking God what he's going to do, one of the other guys yell for him to come over. And you'll hear this.
Javier.
Now, Javier is his name.
What are you doing?
But he's not the right Javier.
$150 standing in the street.
It's a different guy that was supposed to show up, and he doesn't know who he is, so he just got a job. God answered his prayer. This part's sad.
Truck driver and a four-way stop on M17. Nathan would get Victoria. It doesn't look good, Adam. I'm sorry.
Oh, God, help my daughter. Please.
God, a parent's worst nightmare. But you still are not supposed to give up on God.
Make sense of this for me.
He realizes he needs to talk to his son more.
How'd you get in here? See how you were doing.
Is anybody doing okay around here?
I want to know what God expects of me as a father. And I want to know how to help my wife and my son.
You to drive me to the mall, get you some new running shoes. If you don't mind, I might get a pair for myself.
Are you serious?
See, he's spending more time with his son now, realizing that he needs to do that as a parent.
I wish I would have been a better brother.
See, it brings families closer. Even through a tragedy.
Because the Bible says that God is a good judge, and he will punish the guilty not for what they did right, but
but for what they did wrong.
Amen.
Because he loved us, he sent his son, Jesus Christ, to take the punishment that we deserved and put it on himself. And that's why he died on the cross. But it only applies if you accept it.
I love this part.
That's why I ask for his forgiveness.
Lord, thank you for the 9 years I had him over.
He went to the spot where they danced.
I'm grateful. I don't know if I can ask this. Would you tell her I did my side of the dance?
He did a small dance there with her as if she was there.
Justice.
They're all taking an oath to God right now.
I will treat others with kindness, respect, and compassion.
I will work diligently to provide for the needs of my family.
I will forgive those who have wronged me and reconcile with those who I've wronged. I will walk in integrity as a man answerable to God.
I will seek to honor God, obey his word, and do his will.
As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
Because it is wrong, sir. It would be dishonoring to my God and my family to lie on that report.
This part's cool. They put him to a test at this job to see if he would lie, but he said he can't do it, and because of that, he gets hired.
Do you understand what this may do
for full time on there?
Yes, sir, I do.
That's the guy they needed right there, the one that won't lie.
Javier, may I shake your hand?
So I'm going to end it right here. I just didn't want to show too many clips. I don't want this to not go up. I hope it goes up. I hope you guys get to see this. But definitely look into this movie. A very touching movie. Another test of God. There's so many of them in here. And especially like that end where they were looking for a good guy that wouldn't lie. And everybody was saying they would lie. And finally they found a man of God that said, I can't lie, even if it was going to risk losing his job. But anyways, it was such a good movie, and I hope you guys will look into that. Like I said, I wish I could have showed you more, but I have to be careful. Don't want it to be a copyright. Anyways, hope you guys will check that movie out, and definitely check out that cheeseburger mushroom hot dish. It was very delicious at 6 carbs. I love you all very much. God bless. Take care, and I'll see each and every one of you in my next video.